George Robertson, Labour Party candidate, 18,880. And that George Robertson has been duly elected to serve as Member of Parliament for the Hamilton constituency.
Thank you very much.
It is the witching hour last night, and the new Labour MP for the Scottish constituency of Hamilton enjoys every moment of it. There is double satisfaction for George Robertson. In what will now almost certainly be election year, he has given Prime Minister Jim Callaghan cheer and brought the Scottish National Party bandwagon to an abrupt halt in the very town where it began its spectacular journey.
In this election, we put the issue, the great constitutional issue of this time, of independence or separation, clearly, and we asked the people of Hamilton on behalf of the people of Scotland to make a decision on it. That decision has been taken, and the ramifications of that decision will echo well beyond Hamilton and well beyond Scotland.
The basic contention was that Scotland is too poor, the Scots people are too weak, the Scots people are too stupid to do what other economies in the world are managing to do just now. And that is...
Margo MacDonald strove at every opportunity to make the economic case for independence. But in a constituency where 11% of the workforce are on the dole, there was an understandable caution. It seemed as if the voters were saying, better the crisis we know than the new one we may create for ourselves.
That you ignore the fact that in this campaign, the Labour candidate has got as close to the working class as I have got to the man in the moon.
We're needing a change in Scotland, the whole of Scotland. We're needing the SNP.
Scotland will never be able to stand alone.
I reckon.
They can't stand alone. What do we produce? They're shutting your coal mines. You're talking about your oil. Where else has Scotland gone?
Who is they?
They've got nothing else in Scotland.
Excuse me, who's they?
They're part of an English firm that we'll need to rely on. But that's all Scotland's got.
Lark Hall Miners Welfare Club. It is customary in Scotland to refer to Lark Hall as the birthplace of socialism. If that is so, there are men here who remember the labour pains. Yet in 1967, Winnie Ewing succeeded in capturing a substantial part of the Lark Hall vote. It was probably the SNP's most successful foray into the working class heartland. But in 1978, not only was it difficult to find Margot supporters, it was almost impossible to find anyone who would admit to having strayed from the socialist path in the past. Again, the SNP's failure to make an economic case for independence seemed crucial.
All they can talk about is North Sea oil, the revenue coming off the North Sea oil. For instance, Margaret MacDonald is going about saying that each individual person in Scotland is going to receive £3 per head per week. Now, let's take it now. That's coming to close to £30 million. Tell me it's spying, this guy. Not my opinion on it.
No, I say Scotland couldn't go it alone.
Did you vote for the SNP back in 67?
No, I did not.
But a lot of your friends must have done.
Well, I know.
Why did they vote for them then?
They were protesting against the Labour government.
Do you want the devolution and the assembly that you're going to get from the Labour government?
Well, I think it's so. I would like them independent. Don't get me wrong, I would like the Scotland independent, but I don't think we could go alone. We couldn't run it ourselves. We still need to hurt in the Westminster.
So if you want an independent Scotland, but you won't vote for the SNP?
I don't think they can do it. I don't think so.
It was almost impossible to find anyone who would admit to having strayed from the socialist path in the past. Again, the SNP's failure to make an economic case for independence seemed crucial.
All they can talk about is North Sea oil, the revenue coming off the North Sea oil. For instance, Margaret MacDonald is going about saying that each individual person in Scotland is going to receive £3 per head per week. Now, let's take it now. That's coming to close to £30 million. Tell me it's spying, this guy. Not my opinion on it.
No, I say Scotland couldn't go it alone.
Did you vote for the SNP back in 67?
No, I did not.
But a lot of your friends must have done.
Well, I know.
Why did they vote for them?
Abrupt halt in the very town where it began its spectacular journey.
In this election, we put the issue, the great constitutional issue of this time, of independence or separation, clearly, and we asked the people of Hamilton on behalf of the people of Scotland to make a decision on it. That decision has been taken, and the ramifications of that decision will echo well beyond Hamilton and well beyond Scotland.
The basic contention was that Scotland is too poor, the Scots people are too weak, the Scots people are too stupid to do what other economies in the
world. Well, where has Scotland got?
Who is they?
They've got nothing else in Scotland.
Excuse me, who's they?
They're part of an English firm that we'll need to rely on. But that's all Scotland's got.
Lark Hall Miners Welfare Club. It is customary in Scotland to refer to Lark Hall as the birthplace of socialism. If that is so, there are men here who remember the labour pains. Yet in 1967, Winnie Ewing succeeded in capturing a substantial part of the Lark Hall vote. It was probably the SNP's most successful foray into the working class heartland. But in 1978, not only was it difficult to find Margot supporters...
...what all they're managing to do just now.
Margot MacDonald strove at every opportunity to make the economic case for independence. But in a constituency where 11% of the workforce are on the dole, there was an understandable caution. It seemed as if the voters were saying better the crisis we know than the new one we may create for ourselves.
That you ignore the fact that in this campaign the Labour candidate has got as close to the working class as I have got to the man in the moon.
We're needing a change in Scotland, the whole of Scotland. We're needing the SNP.
Scotland will never be able to stand alone.
Aye, they can.
They can't stand alone. What do we produce? They're shutting your coal mines. You're talking about your oil.
George Robertson, Labour Party candidate, 18,880. And that George Robertson has been duly elected to serve as Member of Parliament for the Hamilton constituency.
Thank you very much.
It is the witching hour last night, and the new Labour MP for the Scottish constituency of Hamilton enjoys every moment of it. There is double satisfaction for George Robertson. In what will now almost certainly be election year, he has given Prime Minister Jim Callaghan cheer and brought the Scottish National Party bandwagon to an